What's up guys, welcome back to the channel, and in today's video I'm going to be sharing with you guys how I was able to transform my chest, my pecs, from this to this. So I understand that it's not like the biggest transformation, but I still do honestly believe that it is a notable transformation. Of course, there is a 6-year gap in between these photos, so there's, you know, in every video of how to progress or how to transform, there's always going to be hard work and consistency that's going to be underneath that. But in this specific video, I want to share with you guys the specific action, the specific approach that I personally took to make this transformation happen without actually bench pressing. And the reason why I wanted to make sure that in the title of this video that I was able to transform my chest or develop my chest without benching is because for the past few decades, or like probably the entire century, if bench pressing was already existed back then, is that whenever we think about chest training, the key exercise that everyone would automatically think of would be the bench press. And a lot of people do argue that it's the key movement when it comes to both size and strength. And I'm not going to say that's absolutely wrong. It's just that, I mean, we understand, we know everyone, like almost everyone, has definitely benefited from doing the bench press, both in a size and strength point of view. But for me, that wasn't the case. Again, I'm going to speak from personal experience. I wasn't able to really continually bench for a long time, especially heavy, because of a shoulder birth defect that I have. So I don't want to go into detail with that. But for me, whenever I try to bench press often and frequently heavy, or the moment I touch near around 200 pounds, almost all the time I have pain in my shoulder. And I don't think it's because I have poor technique, because I've had a lot of powerlifting coaches look at me and they say that my bench looks absolutely fine. I'm not saying that it's the best technique there is, but it's not bad to the point that it's going to warrant immediate injury or immediate pain. There's actually even a point in my life where I just have to unrack an empty barbell of 20 kilos or 45 pounds and I'd immediately feel pain. So it was really bad to that extent. So obviously when I reached that point, I still wanted to, you know, grow my pecs. And for me, the first movement that came to my head that's not the bench press is the push-up. And actually the push-ups are really, really great, and I'm pretty sure a lot of men, especially in their teenage years or like mid-20s, look down at the push-ups because they think that's such a basic movement. And true enough, it is a basic movement, but there are different ways. There are actually many ways on how you can manipulate the push-up to actually benefit you more, to increase the intensity, volume, etc. But the specific thing that I did to help me still, you know, to ensure that my pecs will still grow is by using something like this. These are push-up handles, and this is what this is going to do is to be enable you to do the deficit push-up. What is the deficit push-up? The deficit push-up is when you're actually able to go lower than what you would normally go for in a regular push-up, because obviously when you do reps going to the ground, your face and your stomach or your chest will actually touch the floor, and that's going to cap off your range of motion. But if you put these handles on the floor, you are actually giving yourself, probably depending on your mobility, 2 to 4 inches of an additional range of motion. And as we all know, it's at the bottom part of the push-up or any pressing movement, horizontal pressing movement actually, where your pecs are actually stretched at its most. So because of that, you're able to re-stimulate your pec a bit more without adding much more load. Obviously, once you get efficient with doing the deficit push-ups, what are your next steps? Because obviously, if you're able to do 10 reps, your next goal might be to do 15 quality reps, 20, 30. But when it's 30 onwards and obviously 50 reps, that's just going to be boring already, because if you're at that strength level already, that 40 or 50 reps for a set of push-ups are too easy, that's going to take a long time, probably 2 to 3 minutes, or maybe just 2 minutes. But the first 20 or 30 reps are going to be like a breeze. And we want, whenever we do go to the gym or do a workout, we want things to be as efficient as possible. And doing 40 reps or 50 reps per set, that's not going to be the case. So that is when we have to load our push-ups. Now, how are you going to load it? The very staple DIY way is to wear a backpack and put some weights on it. So if you have plates, barbell plates, or dumbbell plates, just put them in the backpack, and that's going to be great. If you don't have a backpack that you are willing to risk to for it to get damaged because of the excessive load, I would say just have somebody in your house to place any load, whether that be books, water bottles, or anything flat that's not going to fall off. My personal favorite is because it looks badass. I like putting chains around my waist or around my upper back, and that's going to really load the push-up quite well. So again, what's the point of this video? I just wanted to share with everyone that if you cannot bench, and that's true for a lot of people right now, even though it's almost a year into the lockdown already, and I know a lot of people have already acquired their own home gyms, their barbells, their benches, so that they can do it, but not a lot of people have the luxury to do so. Of course, I'm fortunate enough to have had a home gym even way before the pandemic, but of course, push-ups have become my staple when it comes to my pec development. So for everyone out there who is limited to just body weight or, you know, body weight movements, I would say that you have nothing to worry about. If you want to develop your pecs, you develop your chest, the push-ups are a great, great option. So don't feel worried that, oh, I can't bench press, so all my my pecs, my shoulders, my arms are gonna shrink. That's not the case whatsoever. As long as you are smart with your push-up training, I can almost 100% guarantee that you are going to succeed, or you're gonna achieve great things with your pecs, as long as you remember that you have to manipulate the necessary variables. So whether that be the number of sets, reps, the actual tempo, or the pauses actually at the bottom of your reps, then of course, once you graduate from those factors, that's when you might want to consider adding load through dumbbell plates, barbell plates, water bottles, sacks of rice, or even my personal favorite, chains. Again, be creative as much as you can, and I can guarantee that you are still going to progress. So actually, if you like these type of videos where I'm just talking straight to you like I'm a host or something, that's something that I would want some feedback on, because I know a lot of people like these short, I like shorter videos where it's a lot more edits. But for me, just to share you my side, this side of the camera, it does take a while to edit and plan a full script. So instead, I just have my iPad with some notes. So hopefully you like these type of videos. It's like kind of in between a podcast and a short video. Again, your feedback is definitely appreciated, as well as your like and subscribe to the channel. Until then, I'll see you in the next video.